पोटेंशियोमीटर इज एन आइडियल वोल्टमीटर, इट्स अ डिवाइस विच इज यूज टू मेजर द पोटेंशियल. आइडियल वोल्टमीटर बिकॉज वोल्टमीटर डज नॉट एक्चुअली गिव्स द प्रिसाइज मेजर ऑफ द वोल्टेज. It always measures different from the actual value of the voltage. We will see it why. Potentiometer, it consists of this is the main circuit. So we have a very long wire. This is generally of 5 to 10 meters. Battery, then we may have a variable resistance, we have an ammeter just to measure how much current is flowing through this closed circuit. Let this be this EMF BB. We call it main circuit, and there is an attached circuit with it depending on its usage, that is called auxiliary or secondary circuit. Now, let us first see what is the principle on which this device works. We have to measure the potential using this device. Now, see, this positive terminal here is here, so current will flow through this wire. If I take any two points on this wire, say AC, then what will be the potential between these two points? AC, it will be whatever current flowing through it, multiplied by the resistance of AC. Resistance is rho L by A. So potential difference between two points is proportional to the length of that section of the wire. So potential difference between any two points is proportional to the distance between those two points, or the length of the wire between those two points, provided these quantities are constant. How will we state it? There is a wire of one material, there is no change in material. The wire has uniform cross section throughout and a constant current is flowing through it. So for constant current flowing through a wire of uniform cross-sectional area, V is proportional to L. This is the principle of potentiometer. K can be called potential gradient. K is V by L. So, volt per meter. This will be the SI unit for it. Potential gradient. So this is the main circuit and this is the principle. For constant current flowing through a wire, the potential difference between two points is proportional to the distance between the two points, provided constant current is there and wire has uniform cross-sectional area. This is the principle of potentiometer. Now, see, the length of the potentiometer wire is taken very large, because this increases the sensitivity. If L is large, it means the drop in potential will be very less. K will be less. Potential per unit length. Potential drop per unit length will be less. It means, say for example, if the difference between the potential at these two points is 2 volts and the distance between them is 10 centimeters. And then we are taking a voltmeter in which this distance is 2 meters but is still 2 volt. It means per millimeter the drop in potential is less. So the least count of this is reduced. So that's why it is better. It is more precise. Its sensitivity is increased. So L should be taken large. Usually there are potentiometers with length of the wire up to 10 meters. Otherwise 3-4 meters, that is the general length of the potentiometer wire which we use in labs. Okay, now what is the use? How do we make use of this potentiometer to measure either the EMF or the internal resistance? let us see how do we use potentiometer to compare the EMFs. This is the potentiometer, and we have to use it to measure the EMF, to compare the EMFs of two cells. So first let us connect a cell from this point, and through a galvanometer it is connected to a jockey J. Jockey is just like this pen structure. So it is metallic. You can take this as this end, and so this wire is connected to this point, and it is all metal inside with a protective covering which is insulating, and then you have this tip also made up of metal. So advantage is that without actually having the firm connection anywhere on the wire, you can easily shift it on this wire, so wherever you want. When it is here, only this part of the wire is used. When it is here, this part, and so on. So you are free to basically change the length when you are using the jockey. So that's the advantage of using jockey. Okay, now see what will happen. This is the circuit, and let me say that EMF of this is E. How is it used to measure the EMF? We have seen that the potential between any two points vary as we keep on moving on this side. It goes on. More is the length, more is the potential between the two points. So current is coming here. This point is connected to positive, so this is positive, and here the potential is decreasing. Now when we have to move this jockey on this wire, it may happen at certain length. Say for example at C point, when the potential between these two points is equal to the EMF of this cell, what will happen at that point of time? This and this, the potential difference between these two points is same as the potential between these two points. That is, we can say if this has a potential difference, say 2 volt EMF, and this point also has a difference of same 2 volts. So it means no current will flow through this actually. Now there will be no current in this because the potential difference this and this, they are the same for whatever current flowing here. So it means it is just like you have this battery, whatever be the EMF, say 5 volt, and if I connect another battery here with 5 volt difference, it is the potential difference which governs the flow. So here no current will flow through this part, I will be zero. So it means no current here in this part. So potential difference between AC is equal to E, and potential difference between AC is K into L. If I take this L length of this part. So if I have to measure, I have to compare the EMFs of two cells, what we can do, we can use the two cells one by one. First I use with a cell of EMF this, and let us say that with this cell I get null point at L1. Then I use another cell, and with that cell I can have, this is E2. And then we can have individual keys here, K1, here K2. So we may include one by one. With E2, I am getting it at L2. So what will happen? E1 by E2 will be L1 by L2. This is how we can find out the ratio of EMFs of two cells. And if we are given one cell is a standard, we can find out the EMF of another cell. You can see again what we have to do. We have to slide this jockey on this wire. We have to shift this till there is a null point. Null point means now the potential difference across it equals this. So no current will flow through this. in that situation, the potential difference between these two points equals the EMF. And potential difference between these two points is proportional to length. So we can say that E1 is equal to KL1. And then we can repeat this with another cell. So E1 is KL1. Then E2 is KL2. Take the ratio L1 by L2 is E1 by L2. This is how we can compare the EMFs. Another application may be we can use it to find out the internal resistance of a cell. Now see what is the difference in that case. This is the cell, and I will show it with the internal resistance this time, and then again through a galvanometer connect it to a jockey, but this time there is a difference. We have a resistance connected across this cell. And it is to be done in two steps. First, keep K open. This is the first case. So if we keep K open, it means no current is flowing through this. So again, we will get a position where, say for example, we get null point at C and AC is L1, so E is equal to potential difference between the two points, which is KL1. Okay, just as we did last time. So no current passing, this is not included because this is off. So potential difference between these two points, when it is equal to E, there will be no current in the galvanometer, and E will be equal to K into the length of this part. Now, second step, keep K closed. Closed means now current is flowing through this. Even now, see when, and suppose now the null point is at D. So what does it mean? That potential difference between A and D, wherever this is, suppose it is this, is equal to the potential difference across this cell. Even now, when there is no current, it means potential difference between these two points equals the potential difference. It was earlier also. But when no current is flowing through this and only cell is connected, no current through it means there is no current in even in the cell. But this time, when we have connected a parallel resistance, no current in galvanometer does not mean no current in the cell, because the current might be flowing like this. No current is going here because the potential difference between these two points equals the potential difference between. So VAD is equal to what? The potential difference between these two points, which is not actually E. It is not E this time because current is flowing through it. And cell is discharging. When it discharges, what is the potential difference? It is actually E minus IR. So whenever you provide a parallel path to the current, current is flowing through the cell, then the potential difference between the terminals is no longer E. It is E minus IR if the cell is discharging. So now, how will we write the expression? And this will be equal to K L2. So we have now L1 upon L2 is equal to E upon E minus IR. This is a very important expression to find out the internal resistance. We still need to find out in terms of R. So from this circuit, what is I? E upon R plus R. So we can substitute this value here. I can write it L2 upon L1 is E minus IR upon E, which is 1 minus IR upon E, and this becomes 1 minus R upon E into I, E upon R plus R. So this gets cancelled. It is 1 minus R upon R plus R. So this is L2 by L1. So L2 by L1 is R upon R plus R. Or we can rearrange the term. R plus R upon R is L1 by L2. L1 by L2 minus 1, or this is the expression which can be used to find out the internal. It is just substitution and all that. That's not so difficult task. You have to understand formation of this. That's the most important thing. So when no current flowing, again, see what is happening here. When no current is flowing through this, potential difference between these two points equals the EMF. But when current is flowing through it, the potential difference between these two points is equal to the potential difference across the terminals, which is no longer E now. In case current is flowing, it is actually E minus IR. That's it. That's the only difference. So whenever you provide a parallel path to the current, the potential difference across the terminals no longer remains EMF. It is less than EMF when the cell is discharging. So this is how it can be used. Take negative on this side, then this potential difference will never be equal to this. So two very important points in this. Firstly, all positive together. Right? Otherwise, the potential difference will never be equal to this. If this is plus, this is minus, and this is minus, this is plus, so it will not be in the same direction, the current. Secondly, EMF of the main battery should always be more than E. What does it mean? This V should be more than this, because only then the potential difference across this will be equal to this. If this is less than this, then the potential difference between these two points will never be equal to this. What can be the maximum potential between these two points? V. So it needs to be more than this. Only then, by removing it, by moving it towards right, you can have a condition when the potential difference equals this. If this is less than this, then even the potential between the two extremes will be less than this. So you will never be able to get the null point. Three points are to be kept in mind when we are talking about the potentiometer. All positive together, V should be equal to the, and third, keep in mind about the length. Bigger is the length, more sensitive the voltmeter is, because the potential drop is less, potential gradient is less, which means the potential is falling gradually now. So even a small section of length can measure some potential. So that's always a good potentiometer. Now, why do we call it an ideal voltmeter? It's an ideal voltmeter because when you are measuring the EMF, it is based on null point method. So it's not taking any current from the cell. Now see this. At null point, it doesn't draw any current from it. So it will give the precise value of E1. While it doesn't happen in case of a voltmeter. What happens in voltmeter? Let me tell you. If I want to measure the potential between these two points, say, let me say it is 10 ohm and 1 ampere current is flowing through it. So potential difference between these two is 10 volt. Now, I take a voltmeter and connect it here. Now voltmeter has some resistance, so some current will flow through it. Now this is not getting 1 ampere current, it is getting less than 1, maybe say 0.9. So if it is getting 0.9, it may be 10 into not 1, 0.9. So it will be just 9 volt, not 10. So whenever we connect a voltmeter, the same will happen in case of a cell. If I use a voltmeter to check the EMF, there is an internal resistance, so current will start flowing, so it will read E minus IR. It will never read, so voltmeter always read E minus IR, it never reads E. While the potential difference reads E, null point method means we try to get a position where there is null point, no current is drawn from the cell. That's why it gives precise value of EMF. So that's all in potentiometer.